Hello, sound check, sound check. Are we live? Yes, I think we're live. We are up, so we may start. Last meeting, we discussed what psychology is in general terms. In that lesson, if I'm not mistaken, we defined what psychology is. I explained to you why psychology is a science. How is psychology different from other fields such as psychiatry? I even introduced you to the different professional organizations that manage psychological research in the Philippines and abroad. So what you learned from last meeting are very general ideas about the field of psychology. Today, I'm very excited kasi pag-uusapan na natin yung mga specific things about the field of psychology. And the first topic we are going to discuss on those deeper things about psychology is I am going to teach you how to explain human behaviors. Sa Tagalog, paano magpaliwanag ng mga ginagawa ng tao, like a psychologist would. As you can see on the slide, this is part 1 of our discussion kasi meron itong part 2, no? So, para hindi tayo masyadong mahaba, I divided this lesson into 2 parts. So, the next video that I'm going to upload or I'm going to deliver will be part 2 of this lesson. I would like to emphasize on those words, like a psychologist would. That's very important. Like a psychologist would. What's my point? Bakit kinakailangan i-emphasize ko pa, like a psychologist would? Because, let me tell you, there are 2 ways on how to make sense of human behaviors. Okay? Yung unang way is, you can analyze human behaviors, and many people do this, in the chismosa level. Yan ang tawag ko dyan, chismosa level. Ito. Anong ibig sabihin ng chismosa level? People in the streets, vendors, jeepney drivers, people walking around the streets, bystanders, they also make sense or can explain human behaviors, di ba? Pinapaliwanag nila, bakit hindi pa sila binabayaran sa utang ng friend nila, bakit sila iniwan ng kanilang mga jowa, di ba? They make sense of behaviors of our politicians. They also have their way of explaining human behavior. But let me tell you that the way they explain human behavior is far away, very different from what I call the psychology level. Ikaw, bilang isang psych major, because you are enrolled in LaSal to be awarded a psych degree, you need to learn the skill of analyzing or making sense of human behaviors in the psychology level, the way of science. Kasi kung ihahalintulad mo lang yung sarili mo sa mga chismosa level, if you are going to explain people the way these people do it, then baliwala lang yung degree mo being a psych major. After all, ang mahal-mahal lang tuition sa LaSal, so you really need to make your money worth by learning the different skills that you can use to really make sense properly of on how to explain human behaviors. And let me tell you, this is very important. When you learn how to explain things in the psychology way, in the scientific way, okay, the way you explain human behaviors will be more truthful, more accurate, and more useful, which is what we want. Ayaw natin na yung mga explanations natin ay puro empty speculations. Empty speculations belong to the chismosa level. And usually, when you say things with empty speculations, most of the time, you are wrong. So if you want to increase your chances that what you say is right, what you say is correct, gusto naman natin yun. Makatotohanan yung mga sinasabi natin. One way to ensure that is really to study the psychological way on how to make sense of people's behavior. And that's exactly what we are going to do today. And the way we will do that is, we are going to answer a very important question. Why do people act the way they do? So lahat ng sasabihin ko ngayon, all concepts I'm going to discuss will revolve around this question. Why do people act the way they do? Okay? I hope you are excited already, no? Let's move on to the next slide. Alam nyo, To answer this question, most psychologists use the following explanations. We have psychodynamic explanation, behavioral explanation, cognitive explanation, biopsychological explanation, evolutionary, and social-cultural explanation. Six different ways on how to make sense of people's behaviors. Another term for the word explanation is ito yung tinatawag nating theories, mga teorya. Ano ba ang silbi ng isang teorya? Theory of evolution, Big Bang Theory. Theories are made to explain how something happens. In the same way, kapag sinabi mong theories in psychology or different ways of explaining behaviors in psychology, ang ginagawa natin is we are answering the question, again, why? Why do people behave the way they do? We are going to use these theories para masagot yung tanong na yan. Okay. Now, for today, we are going to simply discuss numbers 1, 2, and 3 para hindi tayo masyadong mahaba. Our next lesson, the next installment for this lesson will be numbers 4, 5, and 6. So, let's go directly to number 1. Okay? Psychodynamic explanation. How do you make sense of people's actions using the psychodynamic explanation? One big name to remember here is none other than Sigmund Freud. Huwag na huwag niyong kakalimutan yung pangalan na yan, ha? Pag narinig niyo yung pangalan na Sigmund Freud, okay, always remember that he is all about the psychodynamic explanation of human behaviors. The first thing you have to know about Sigmund Freud is he's dead. Matagal na siyang wala, so huwag niyo na siyang hanapin, ha? He's gone. But when he was still alive, he was very particular to this question. Why do people behave the way they do? Ano ang sagot niya? If he was still alive, his answer would be, people behave the way they do because of invisible psychological entities in the mind. Those words in green are very important. Kasi raw, kaya ka raw ganyan, kaya ka late gumising ng umaga, kaya ka magagalitin, kaya ka mapili sa pagkain, the reason why you hurt other people, it has something to do with psychological entities inside your mind. So I would like everyone to please hold your heads right now. Hold your heads. All together, hold your heads. Deep inside your head is your brain, and that brain contains the mind. According to Freud, your mind is controlled by or is ruled by these three psychological entities. Siguro naman na pag-usapan nyo to nung kayo ay nasa senior high school. May pangalan nga yung tatlong yan, no? We have the id, the ego, and the super ego. I'm sure familiar kayo sa mga yan. So those are the three entities that constantly affect what we do in our everyday life. I want to take note of this. I want to emphasize on this. I mean, please emphasize this. What Freud is saying is these entities are not literal. Ibig sabihin, when you open up a person's head, you don't literally see the id, ego, and super ego. You cannot see them because according to Freud, they are in the form of, this is very important, energy. Energy ang mga yan. Hindi mo makikita yan. Or to use the language of Star Wars, forces. Mga psychological forces yan inside our mind. But again, even if they are not literal, even if they are forces, these forces constantly affect the things that we do in our everyday life. So this is what Freud is focusing on whenever he makes sense of people's behaviors. Now, it's very important that you know the differences among these three entities. Let's talk about the three. Anong ibig sabihin ng id? According to Freud, id is the force in your head, in your mind, that constantly tells you to experience pleasure immediately. Let me repeat, experience pleasure immediately. Everything that you feel that has something to do with you wanting yourself to experience a certain kind of pleasure, that is the influence of the id. Sa Tagalog, kasarapan. Tuwing naghahanap ka ng mga bagay-bagay na masasarap, yan, everybody say that with me, sarap. That is the influence of the id. Kapag halimbawa, gusto mo pang matulog, ayaw mo pang mag-prepare sa online class, gusto mo pang matulog because it's rainy, bad weather. Yan, that's your id telling you to stay in bed. Kapag nakakita ka ng mga pagkain at gusto mong ubusin lahat ng nasa lamesa kasi masarap yung ulam, ayaw mo magtira para sa iba, that's your id. Or nag-online gaming ka, talagang enjoy na enjoy ka sa paglalaro kahit na meron ka pang assignment, that force that tells you to continue playing online games and not review, that's your id telling you to continue playing. Okay, so anything pleasurable, that's the influence of the id. Unfortunately, meron tayong kasabihan sa Tagalog, halos lahat ng masasarap bawal. And at some point, that's true. That's why if you keep on listening to your id, you end up doing a lot of things that are not good. Although it feels right, it doesn't necessarily mean it's good. Buti na lang, sabi ni Freud, meron tayong tinatawag na super ego. What is the super ego? Super ego is the part of yourself that tells you to do what is right, also known as your conscience. Most of the time, your super ego tells you what others want, the conventions, the responsibilities, lahat yan. Yan yung influence ng tinatawag nating super ego. And if you notice, yung super ego, it is constantly contradicting the desires of your id. It is contradicting the desires of your id. Magkasalungat or magkabaliktad. Polar opposites. Your id tells you to do what is pleasurable while your super ego will block, will deflect what your id wants to do. Kaya lagi magkaawa yung id and super ego. Sabi ng id mo, continue sleeping because it feels good to sleep. Sabi ng super ego mo, you have to wake up because that is the behavior of a responsible student. Kailangan gumising ka na. Diba? Sabi ng id mo, kainin mo lahat ng pagkain sa lamesa. Sabi naman ng super ego mo, huwag mong gawin yan kasi importante na protektahan mo yung health mo. Mahirap magkasakit ngayong pandemic. Baka tumaas ang blood sugar mo, tumaas ang blood pressure mo, mahirap magpa-check-in sa mga ospital kapag inatake ka sa puso. So again, they are always in contradiction to each other, the id and the super ego. According to Freud, it is not good for our mind that it only has id and super ego. Bakit? If you notice, if you only have the id and the super ego, it will always create psychological tension. Kasi they are opposites eh. Parang tinatag of war ka sa pag-iisip mo, and that is very mentally draining. Diba? One part of you tells you to do it, another part of you tells you not to do it. Nakaka-experience ka ng tension, and that's not good. Too much tension in the psyche, it's not good, sabi ni Freud. Kaya buti na lang, sabi ni Freud, merong ego na bumabalanse between the id and the super ego. So ego, ang pinaka-function talaga niya is to bridge or is to reconcile the id and the super ego. In what way? In what way the ego balances the id and the super ego? Well, the ego will find a way kung papaano niya mapagbibigyan pareho yung desires ni id at ni super ego. Para hindi ano, para walang matatalo, the ego will try to integrate both drives. What's the drive of the id? We will combine it with the drive of the super ego so that both will be happy. In what way? Let me give you an example. Halimbawa, you have a problem in money. Namumroblema ka for your tuition fee next term. Now, let's say one day, you are sitting in a mall, and then a person gets his wallet. Without him knowing it, yung wallet na kinuha niya, nahulugan siya ng pera. And you saw the money fall into the ground. Now, in that situation, according to Freud, the id, ego, and super ego begin to work. The forces begin to work. You feel the forces. So the id will tell you to get the money. Remember, the id is very what? It's very prone to tell you what is pleasurable. Diba? Masarap kumuha ng pera na hindi sa'yo. Masarap na kumuha ng pera na hindi mo pinaghirapan. Solve agad ang problema mo. Because the id is very selfish. And a lot of the things that id wants you to do, it's not legal. It's even not moral. Right? That's the id. But you will not immediately get the money because there will be the influence of the superego. Sasabihin ng superego mo, hindi mo pwedeng gawin yan because that is considered stealing. And stealing is bad. You're a Christian. You are reading the Bible. You are the Bible study leader of your church. Diba? Tinuruan ka pa naman ng pastor nyo. Diba? Yung parents mo, pinapapunta ka pa naman sa Sunday school. This is the time to apply Christian principles. Don't get the money. Now you are torn. The psyche does not know what to do. Buti na lang, here's the ego to the rescue. The ego will find a way on how to integrate the desires of the id and the superego. And there are many ways how to do that. Can you think of one? One way to do it is, you get some and you return some. So kunin mo yung pera, kuha ka ng konti, yung natira, ibalik mo sa may-ari. Diba? Pag tinanong ka, bakit kulang to, sabihin mo lang, di mo alam. Pero bakit naging ego yon? Because in that strategy, if you notice, you are able to listen to your id. Napagbigyan mo yung id mo, di ba? Kumuha ka ng konting pera para mabawas-bawasan yung problema mo. But you also listen to your superego. You did not get everything. Right? At least you returned some. O, di ba? E di, nabalance ni ego yung id and superego. Okay, another strategy given that situation. For example, you can do it this way. You get the money and then you return it to the owner and then maybe you can ask for a reward. Pwede rin yun. Asking for a reward after doing something good, that's the influence of the id. You deserve to be rewarded because you are honest. Nasaan naman yung superego doon? Hindi mo naman kinuha yung pera, which is good. Diba? That's the function of the ego. It always find ways, really, to integrate the desires of both the id and the superego. Okay? So, I hope you understand how these three entities or energies influence what we do. Now, among these three, the id, ego, and superego, according to Freud, pinaka dapat mag-ingat pala tayo is the id. Yes, the id. Hindi pwedeng sa buhay natin, puro lang natin pinapagana yung id natin. In fact, if you read Freud's teachings about the psyche, he was saying that one of the things that we really need to ensure in our lives is we need to tame the id. Lahat naman ng tao may id. Pero we need to find ways on how to control it, how to manage it, how to tame it. Because if a person is ruled by the id, if the id becomes out of control, then bad things might happen. Okay? One illustration para mas maintindihan nyo how the id can be so wild and how it can affect your behaviors in negative ways. Take for instance, when a person takes illegal drugs. One of the negative things, undesirable outcome of taking illegal drugs is it over magnifies the energy of the id. Pinapalakas niya ng sobra-sobra yung puwersa ng id. In what way? Take for example, this illustration. So let's say someone is taking drugs. Ang nangyayari kasi, when you take drugs, the chemicals that enter your mind, it will weaken, it will kill, it will weaken or it will kill the forces of the ego and the superego. And that's dangerous. Because remember, it is the ego and the superego who is controlling the very powerful id. So imaginein mo, wala kang ego, wala kang superego. Id lang meron ka. That is not good. This person, I would say, is very scary. Nakakatakot kausap, nakakatakot kasama ang isang taong wala ng sense of conscience, wala ng sense of practicality or reality. Lahat na lang ng kanyang gagawin, it's ruled by the id. And this explains why when you watch the news, marami tayong mga nababalitaan ng mga behaviors, you cannot even imagine how people are able to do such behaviors. Diba? Na-feel nyo na ba yun? Yung kapag nanonood kayo ng balita, yung sobrang karumal-dumal nung ginawa ng tao, and you wonder, tao pa ba ang gumawa nito? Tao pa ba ang gumawa niyan? Kaya ba talagang gawin ng tao yan? The answer, according to Freud, yes, people can do such things, especially when the id overpowers the ego and the superego. Now, did you know that the Bible also describes someone, the psyche of a person, who is overruled by the id? And the Bible was very accurate on this, okay? Ang sinabi ng Bible sa 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1, very related to what Freud said regarding the id. But realize this, that in the last days, difficult times will come. For men will be lovers of self, lovers of money, boastful, arrogant, revilers, disobedient to parents, ungrateful, unholy, unloving, irreconcilable, malicious gossips, without self-control, brutal, haters of good, treacherous, reckless, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, holding to a form of godliness although they have denied its power. Avoid such men as this. Everything that you can see here, diba? Lahat ng makita mo dyan, no? Being lover of the self, unholy, unloving, brutal, haters of good, these are all the drives of the id. Somebody who is ruled by the id, ito yung kanilang magiging pattern of behavior. And it's very scary to be with someone na ganyan ang ugali, na ganyan ang behavior. Okay? So that's what the Bible says about the id. Now, this is a very common question that students ask me whenever I teach this lesson. Who among the three wins? The id, ego, and superego, sino ang nananalo? Sino ang nagdo-dominate? The answer there is, it depends from person to person. That's how Freud will answer this. Depends from person to person. Sadyang merong mga tao, for example, ang kanilang dominance is yung kanilang id. Some people have dominant superego. Some people have dominant egos. And that is where personality differences enter the picture. You will be talking about personality differences when you enter the subject theories of personality. Pag-uusapan nyo yan, no? Bakit ba yung tao nagiging dominant sa id? While some people are dominant in superego, while some are dominant in their ego, there are explanations there. But for the meantime, ang gagawin lang muna natin dito is to study the personality profile of a person dominant in id versus dominant in superego versus dominant in ego. If a person, for example, is dominant in the id, yan yung dominant sa kanya, generally that person you can say is very immature. Yan, immature yung taong yan. Sa Tagalog, isip bata or parang bata. May kakilala ba kayong ganyan? Isip bata, parang bata. Ano yung mga kaugalian niyan? Ayan, no? Demanding, selfish, cold, irresponsible, ano? Unfaithful in relationships. Nako, lalong-lalo na to, unfaithful in relationships. Kasi walang maturity sa relationship eh. Tuwing nag-aaway, break agad. Or tuwing may nakikita na mas maganda o mas pogi, sumasama ka agad. O, kung saan siya nakakahanap ng pleasure, doon siya pupunta. Some people are like that kasi ang dominant sa kanila yung kanilang id. And most of them are considered worldly in the language of the Bible. They are the friends of the world. They are the lovers of the world. Ang paborito nilang gawin is to eat, drink, buy the things that they want because tomorrow you will die. Oh, may kakilala ba kayong ganyan ng ugali? If you know anyone who is like that, what does that mean? How do you explain that behavior? Yung dominance nila is the force of the id. One good character that I could think of na kasyang-kasya dito sa ganitong profile is the character of Joker. Kung mapapanood nyo yung movie ni Batman, the way Joker moves, the way he behaves, how he thinks, what are the things that he does, I would say, si Joker talaga eh dominant ang kanyang id. How about those people who are dominant in their superego? In our language, we call them having a conservative personality. Another word for conservative, di ba yung tinatawag nating traditional? Or quote-unquote, close-minded, di ba? Napaka-close-minded mo naman. Modern times na, ganyan ka pa rin mag-isip. We call them conservative. Ano ang profile ng isang taong very conservative? Well, they are very obedient. They are very principled. Traditional, yeah, sinabi ko kanina yan, they're very helpful, they are always concerned with other people, they are very loving to the point they become martyrs, di ba? May kakilala ba kayong ganun? They are ready to sacrifice themselves for the sake of other people. Lalong-lalo na yung mga battered wives, yung mga ginugulpe ng mga asawa. Di ba? Araw-araw na silang ginugulpe, wala nang respeto sa kanila, yung asawa nila, and yet, they still stay in the relationship for the sake of the kids. Diba? Kahit na nasasaktan na siya, kahit na binabastos na siya nung asawa niya, well, for them, it's okay. For the sake of the kids. Ayaw ko kasing lumaki yung mga anak ko na walang kinikilalang kumpletong pamilya. So kapag ganyan mag-isip, ganyan yung pattern ng isang tao, malamang dominant ang superego niyan. How about those people who are dominant with their ego? In general, they are called to have a very practical personality. Or kung sa salitang Tagalog, ewan ko lang kung narinig nyo na, sila ay napaka mga tuso. Diba, tanong nyo sa mga parents yung anong ibig sabihin ng tuso. But it's very related to the word practical. They know how to balance the drives, the selfish drives that they have while not being caught by the society. Nababalanse nila. Nagagawa nila yung gusto nila. At the same time, it appears that they are following the norms of the society. Okay? Kapag ganyan yung personality profile mo, dominant ang iyong ego. Specific profiles are the following. Diba? They are very street smart. They are very resourceful. They are good problem solvers. And a lot of them are manipulative. Some examples of characters that I know na ganyan ang personality profile would be Sherlock Holmes and Mr. Bean. Diba? Yan yung common nila eh. Diba? Yung they are doing what they want. They are doing what makes them happy. In a way, they are selfish, but they can also balance other people. They can also balance the desires of other people. It does not appear that they are very selfish. Pero ang hindi alam ng mga tao, they have their own ways of satisfying their selfish desires. Now, after everything I've said about how Sigmund Freud sees human behaviors, ano ba yung life application natin dito? Actually, what the psychodynamic explanation is teaching us is the importance of balance. In fact, according to Freud, if you want to have a good mental health, kinakailangan, that's your goal. You need to achieve balance in your life. And among the three, id, ego, and superego, it is the ego that is really concerned about balance. Diba? Ego talaga yan eh. Ang id tsaka superego extremes. But the ego is the one, it's the force that tells you to achieve balance in life. Kaya nga in the psychodynamic thinking, the healthiest force to really enhance is the ego. Not the id, not the superego, but the ego. It teaches us the importance of achieving balance in our everyday life. And speaking of balance, alam nyo, even in the Bible, tinuturo din yung idea of balance, no? Tinuturo din yung idea na dapat hindi tayo nasa extreme. Like for example, in Matthew chapter 22, verse 39, diba? Love your neighbor as yourself. How many love can you see in this passage? Mahalin mo ang kapwa mo tulad ng pagmamahal mo sa sarili mo. There are two loves here. Love for the self and love for other people. Huwag ka raw magiging extreme. Don't just love yourself. At the same time, don't just love other people. Dapat balanse ka. You love yourself and you also love other people. Anong tawag dyan? Ang tawag dyan, balanse. Even in Buddhism, tinuturo nila yan. No? Ang sabi ni Buddha, give but don't allow yourself to be used. Love but don't allow yourself or your heart to be abused. Trust but don't be naive. Listen but don't lose your own voice. O, diba? That is the idea of balance. Yan yung tinuturo sa atin ng psychodynamic explanation. If we want to be mentally healthy, if we want to be mentally well, we need to find ways on how to achieve balance. Sa Tagalog, hindi pwedeng puro sarili at hindi rin naman pwede na puro ibang tao lang. Hindi pwedeng puro gusto mo lang, hindi rin naman pwede yung puro dapat lang. Kailangan matututo kang magbalanse. And in modern-day psychological research, dito na ngayon papasok yung mga ideas like work-life balance. Diba? Pag binabalanse mo yung mga dapat mong gawin because it's your job, sa mga bagay na gusto mong gawin because you enjoy those things, then we remember the teachings of the psychodynamic perspective. Kaya nga, in psychodynamic explanation, no, pag-aaralan nyo ito in clinical psychology, there is a way on how to strengthen the ego. Kasi may mga tao, for example, wala sila sa balance, no? Masyadong malakas yung id or masyadong malakas yung super ego. Is there a way how to modulate or how to strengthen the ego and then manage the strength of the id and the super ego? Meron. Merong paraan dyan. At ito yung tinatawag natin, ginagawa yan sa psychotherapy. Again, you will talk about this when you take up a subject called clinical psychology. But in psychotherapy, ito, ganito usually yung setup ng mga nagsa-psychotherapy, no? Ito yung nagsa-psychotherapist, ito yung tao na tinetherapy. Ang pinaka-goal talaga niyan is to tame the id and strengthen the ego or the superego. Sadyang meron talagang mga tao na wala sa balance eh. So the psychotherapy will help that person to achieve balance. And just to share with you, meron ding mga libro, no, na nagtuturo kung paano ba palakasin yung ego. Because again, let me repeat, among the three, id, ego, superego, pinaka dapat talaga pinapalakas yung ego. Kaya books like this exist. Ego development, it teaches you how to strengthen the ego over the id and the superego. Okay? I hope you can understand the things that I'm teaching you so far. Now, let's move on to number 2. Another way to make sense of people's behaviors is behavioral explanation. Ano naman pinagkaiba ng behavioral explanation sa psychodynamic explanation? In this explanation, ang ginagawa natin is we believe that people behave or act the way they do because of rewards and punishments. These are two big words, rewards and punishments. Everything you do can be explained by rewards and punishments that you have. Okay, like for example, ano ba yung mga rewards and punishments? Rewards is anything that gives you pleasure or anything that is rewarding. Let's say money, oh, praise from other people, escape from pain or discomfort. Lahat ng masarap can be considered a reward. While punishment is anything that gives you pain or discomfort. Yung napapahiya ka, yung naiinitan ka, o yung ano ba, yung merong masakit sa'yo, or nabawasan yung pera mo. Ayan, lahat yan is considered punishment. So, how does reward and punishment influence our behavior? Very simple principle, everybody. Rewards make us do things, while punishments make us avoid things. The words in color are very important. Rewards make you do things or approach things or behaviors, while punishments make you avoid things or behaviors. Okay, siguro para mas malinaw, let me give you some examples, real-life examples, on how rewards and punishments can explain specific behaviors. Let's talk about yung usong-uso ngayon, addiction to computer gaming. Maraming na-addict dyan, di ba? Oh, online gaming, 10 oras naglalaro, hindi kumakain, hindi na natutulog, hindi na gumagawa ng assignment. Bakit? How do you explain that? Bakit ang isang tao ma-addict sa online gaming? Because that person experiences a lot of rewards from playing the game. Remember the principle, any behavior that gives you rewards, you run after it, you approach it. Ano ba yung mga rewards when you play computer games? You experience excitement, a sense of accomplishment, nawawala yung stress mo, nalilimutan mo yung problema mo, at syempre, nagiging malakas yung bonding ng friendship nyo kasi magkakampi kayo eh. Diba? Lalo na kapag yung magkakakampi, nanalo. Diba? At nung nanalo kayo, meron kayo natanggap na malaking pera kasi yung laro pala, pustahan. O, pinagmumulan din yan ng online gambling. Diba? So, maraming mga kabataan ngayon, many young people today, are into such online gambling. So, sana huwag kayong ganyan, no? But that's how we make sense of computer addiction. Young people experience a lot of rewards, so they get addicted to online gaming. Now, let's analyze one behavior that many young people today don't like to do. At bakit ayaw nilang gawin yon? Let's talk about going to class. O, di ba? Lalo na nung face-to-face, maraming mga estudyante nagka-cutting classes. If you notice, cutting classes is actually a form of behavior where you run away from behavior. You avoid the behavior. You avoid going to that class. Oh, how do you make sense of that? Using behavioral explanation, punishments. Bakit ayaw pumasok? Paano? Maraming punishments kapag pumapasok. Some examples, the class is boring. Diba? Students are not interested with the way the teacher teaches the subject. Mahirap yung lesson. Students feel incompetent. Mahirap na nga yung lesson, tapos anong nangyari? Nagpa-quiz pa. At nung nag-quiz, bagsak. So you feel bad about yourself. Bumababa yung self-esteem mo. Bumababa yung self-efficacy mo. Some teachers are very critical. Hindi na nga nila naintindihan yung lesson. Bagsak na nga sila sa quiz. Pinagalitan pa nung teacher bakit bagsak sa quiz. So you add this up. Boring, hard lessons, critical teachers, boom. Ano mangyayari? Well, students more likely would not like to go to that class. Kaya minsan maiintindihan mo rin no? Like for example, pag lunch break, tapos merong next class, and the class is punishing, and then students know that meron pa silang free time before that class, and then they ask each other, tara, saan tayo? O, diba? And then they have two options. Are we going to play online gaming, or are we going to enter Sir's class na very punishing? The behavioral explanation will predict these students will do the behavior that gives them more rewards and avoid behavior that gives them punishment. No wonder they are going to cut classes. Hindi na lang papasok, mag-online gaming na lang. Yan ang psychology of cutting classes. Okay? Now, what are some life applications that we can learn about behavioral explanations? Very important. Saan ba ginagamit itong mga principles na ito, no? In using rewards and punishments, in making sense of people's actions. Application number one, pay reward for good behaviors, discipline undesirable behaviors. In our everyday life, dapat handa tayong gumawa ng two actions. When it comes to behaviors that are given to us. If you like the behavior that is done to you, nagustuhan mo yung behavior na ginawa sa iyo, i-reward mo yun. You pay that behavior so that that person who did the good behavior to you, gagawin niya ulit. Diba? In a more technical term ang tawag dyan, you reinforce the good behavior that was done to you so that that behavior will be done again. Gagawin niya ulit sa iyo kasi nirewardan mo eh. Pero pag yung behavior na ginawa sa'yo ay pangit, undesirable, ayaw mo, na bad trip ka, then ang gagawin mo is bibigyan mo siya ng disiplina. Or another term for punishment. Diba? At marami itong mga applications. Diba? Like halimbawa, how do we deal with undesirable behaviors? That's the whole essence why we discipline children. Diba? Parental discipline. Bakit ba natin dinidisiplina yung bata? Kailan natin dinidisiplina yung bata kapag gumawa sila ng undesirable behavior? Diba? nagmura, o kaya nagnakaw, o kaya nagsinungaling, o kaya hindi ginawa yung assignment. Yan. Every time the child does that, the parents should react. Dapat merong certain form of discipline na ibibigay so that the child will not do the undesirable behaviors again. Kaya lesson din ito, pag wala namang ginagawang masama yung bata, eh sana huwag silang bigyan ng discipline or ng punishment. Because believe it or not, some parents are like that, no? Oo, yung kahit wala namang ginawang masama yung bata, eh ipapunish, bibigyan ng disiplina, hindi rin naman maganda yon, di ba? Oh, another example, ito, macro level na to in our society, no? Bakit ba yung mga kotse na naka-illegally park sa mga kalsada? Why are the government officials clamping them? Ang tawag dito, clamp. Bakit ba nilalagyan ng clamp yung mga gulong? Kasi undesirable behavior yung ginawa. Kaya hindi nakadaan yung bumbero eh. Kaya hindi nakalabas yung kotse ng may-ari ng bahay. Bakit? May nakaharang na kotse, illegally park. Oh, para turuan ng leksyon yung mga drivers na nag-illegally park. Lalagyan natin ng clamp yan. Diba? At para mabuksan mo yung clamp na yan, you need to go to the city hall and you are going to pay a certain amount of money. If I'm not mistaken, mahal yan eh. Parang 2,500 yata yan. No? Para matanggal mo yung clamp nung, doon sa gulong mo. Para magtanda ka, next time, huwag kang mag-illegal parking. Okay? And that is also the psychology behind why societies use jails. Bakit ba natin kinukulong yung mga offenders of the law to teach them a lesson? To discipline them. So that next time, paglabas nila dyan, magtatanda na sila na huwag na silang gagawa ng masama. Kasi it's a very punishing experience to be inside our jails. Punta naman tayo doon sa baliktad, giving rewards. No? Halimbawa, ginagamit ito in the field of sales and marketing. How do you make people buy your things? Paano mo sila ihihikayat o i-invite na bilhin yung binebenta mo? Tuwing bibili ka sa kanila, bibigyan kanila ng reward para tataas yung chance that you are going to repeat the behavior. So for example, you buy something in SM, bibigyan kanila ng points dito sa iyong advantage card. So that next time that you buy, so that next time you go to the mall, you know you will earn points when you buy, you keep on buying. Diba? Yan yung logic behind that. No? Ginagamitan din yan ng behavioral explanation. No? Let's now move on to relationships. How do you apply this in relationships? That is the reason why you need to be enhancing your friendships. Diba? If you want to strengthen your relationships, your existing relationships, at lahat naman tayo gusto yan, diba? Lahat naman tayo gusto ng stronger relationships, gusto natin ng stronger friendship, more positive experience of friendships. One way to do it is to what? Reward your friends. Reward them. Make sure every time they are with you, they are going to feel they are rewarded by being with you. That's very important. And that idea is very biblical. Ha? Napaka-biblical ng idea na yan. Kaya nga diba sinasabi ng Bible, whenever you are with people that you care about, let us be concerned about one another in order to promote love and good works. Diba? The more you do good things to people, the more you are rewarding them to be with you, the more they would like to be with you. Kaya yung mga kaibigan mo, dapat nililibre mo yan. Dapat lagi kang source ng support, lagi kang source ng encouragement. Hindi yung lagi mo silang inaaway, lagi mo silang inuutangan, tapos hindi mo babayaran. Ikaw na lang lagi yung nililibre, tapos iba-backstab mo pa. Diba? Pag ganun ang ginagawa mo, baliktad. You are a punishing experience for them. It's just a matter of time before they run away from you. Ganun din when it comes to intimate relationships. How do you prevent infidelity? Diba? Bakit ba nagkakaroon ng manloloko sa relationship? How do you make sense of that? Using the behavioral explanation? Well, kaya nagloko yan kasi siguro hindi ka rewarding as a partner. Diba? Kaya ang lesson dito na tinuturo ng behavioral explanation, you need to be a rewarding partner. You make sure that when your partner is with you are giving the basic relational rewards that you need to be giving your partner. At ganun din naman yung partner mo. Diba? Na dapat yung partner mo matututo rin that every time he or she is with you, binibigay din niya yung mga basic rewards na kailangan mo by being in a relationship. Such as what? Ano ba yung mga relational rewards na yan? O pwede nyo itong screenshots, no? O, kayo ba ay nagbibigay sa isa't isa ng attention, care, concern, support, encouragement, resources, positive experiences? I highly recommend you listen to the song of Kenny Rogers. Diba si Kenny Rogers, gumawa siya ng kanta. Ang title ng kanta niya, Through the Years. Bakit yung sa kanta niya na Through the Years, he wants to stay in the relationship with that person? Kasi marami siyang natatanggap ni rewards, rewarding experiences from that person. Diba? Sabi niya dito, you never let me down, you turn my life around, the sweetest days I've found with you. Ano pa? Never been afraid. I've loved the life we've made. Kaya ano ang epekto? I'm so glad I've stayed right here with you through the years. O, diba? Kaya gusto niya magstay sa relationship. Bakit? Kasi marami siyang mga rewards na nakukuha from that relationship. Okay? So, I hope you are learning something, you know, when it comes to how to strengthen your relationships. Kinakailangan marami kang reward na binibigay doon sa taong karelasyon mo. Now, a lot of people are asking me, kapag tinuturo ko ito in connection to relationships, sir, paano naman kung iniwan pa rin ako, inaway pa rin ako, binigay ko naman yung mga rewards. Diba? Meron namang attention, my care, my love, pero hindi pa rin ako ginawa ng maganda. Well, my answer to that question is, well, that is not the right person to be in a relationship with. Diba? Kasi ang normal na tao, when you give them good things, if that person is a decent person, ang reaction niya dapat is to give back. That's why relationships work. You give, and that person gives back. Diba? The relationship becomes symbiotic. Kaya nag-e-exist, kaya nabubuhay yung relationship. One is giving, the other one is also giving. It's symbiotic. So the relationship survives. Now, ikaw yung bigay ng bigay. Ikaw lang yung rewarding. Siya lang yung tanggap ng tanggap. Hindi siya nagbibigay ng mga rewards sa'yo na kailangan mo rin naman. Then, that is a good confirmation that that person is not fit enough to be in a serious relationship. Maliwanag ba? So that's how I will answer that question. I hope you're learning. Now let's move on to psychological explanation number 3. Let's talk about cognitive explanation. This is the last for this part of the lecture, no? Anong ibig sabihin ng cognitive explanation? The word cognitive is very psychological. In fact, meron kayong subject called cognitive psychology. But the word cognitive, just to summarize what cognitive psychology is, we talk about a person's belief system. Or sa Tagalog, mga bagay na pinaniniwalaan mo. Your belief systems. The thing is, your belief system, hindi lang siya nasa ulo mo. Your beliefs are not only inside your heads, but your beliefs have the capability to control or to influence your behaviors. So I want you to say this 3 times. Belief controls behavior. One more time, ready? Belief controls behavior. One more time, belief controls behavior. Yan yung pinaka-idea ng cognitive explanation. Your beliefs will control your behavior. And this is very consistent with a quote coming from Ralph Waldo Emerson na ang sabi niya, diba? And I think he's right when he said this, the ancestor of every action is a thought. Let me repeat, the ancestor of every action is a thought. Kaya ka gumagawa ng isang bagay, your behaviors, hindi siya random. You don't just do things blindly. You always have a reason why you are doing something. And that reason why you are doing something is inside your head. You are believing that it is right to do that something. Let me give you some examples para mas malinaw. Halimbawa, if you are a person who sincerely believes that education is very important, mahalaga na mahalaga yung education para sa'yo, that's a belief, right? It's inside your head. But that is not only a belief. it will affect what you do. It will affect your behavior. And how do you think this will affect your behavior? Because you believe that education is important, look at the effect on your behavior. You are more likely to attend classes. You are more likely to listen to lectures. You are more likely to study for exams. You are more likely to support online learning. You are more likely to read books, so on and so forth. Again, why are you doing these things? Why are you doing these behaviors? Wala lang, hindi. You believe this out of a certain belief. Ganun din naman sa psychology of sports, di ba? Alimbawa, for those of you who are into sports, if a person believes that LeBron James is great, the greatest ever, di ba? Merong debate na ganyan, no? LeBron James ba o Michael Jordan? Let's say you are for LeBron. How do you think that belief will influence your behavior? In a lot of ways. Diba? Because you believe that LeBron James is great, you end up watching Lakers game, you end up buying Lakers jersey or Lakers merchandise, and some fans, yung talagang diehard Laker fans, they are prepared to do this. They will dress up like this. Magsusuot sila ng makeup, ng paint, face paint, just for them to support Lakers. Ang tanong, bakit sila ganyan? Bakit sila ganyan ka-diehard? It has something to do with the way they believe about Lakers. It has something to do with what they believe. I mean, what they believe about the Lakers. May kinalaman talaga yan sa belief. The belief is very powerful in influencing what you do. Kaya yung mga bagay na lagi mong ginagawa, okay, you can trace it back eh. Ano ba yung belief ko? Why am I doing this? Let's say, laging gusto mo, meron kang boyfriend or girlfriend. Diba? What belief is behind that pattern? Or halimbawa, yung isang magnanakaw, it's very interesting. Bakit siya nakaw ng nakaw? Ano ba yung paniniwala niya tungkol sa pagnanakaw? You always trace back the behavior, or you always trace the behavior back to what the person believes. O yung paparating na ano, no? Para nasa context tayo, no? Para ano tayo? Current events. Election. Why would some Filipinos support certain candidates? How would the cognitive explanation make sense of that? Why some Filipinos will support Lacson? Yung iba, Moreno. Yung iba, Robredo. Yung iba, Marcos. Yung iba, Pacquiao. Bakit? Again, you trace that behavior. The behavior here is their support for these candidates. You trace that back to what they believe. Para maintindihan mo. Huwag mo munang sabihin na, kasi mga low IQ kayo. Kasi wala kayong mga sense of history . Kaya nyo sinusuportahan yan. Chismosa level yon. Psychological level, you ask them, what's the reason why you support that candidate? Can you tell me more? What's your basis for saying he or she will be a good leader? That's the cognitive way of making sense of people's behaviors. Going back to your task in the pre-lecture video, di ba? Pinagawa ko sa inyo yung mottos. Ano bang point ng activity na yon? Yung mottos nyo. Yung mga motto na pinaniniwalaan nyo sa buhay nyo. These are not just mottos inside your heads. Do you agree? These mottos have the ability to affect your actions. Let me repeat. Those mottos are not only inside your head, but those mottos, every day, as you wake up in the morning and you do the things that you do, the way you relate with other people, what you prioritize in life, those things are affected by the things that you believe to be true, as reflected by your mottos. Kaya nga gusto ko tong sinabi. Dito, ang ganda ng quote. Your beliefs reflect your choices. Your choices shape your actions. Your actions determine your results. The future you create depends upon the decisions you make and the actions that you take today. Totoo yan. But i-trace back mo yung iyong life condition today. Bakit ka ganyan? You trace it back to where it all started, and that is your beliefs. Kaya napakahalaga talaga, eh, napakahalaga na we need to be sensitive about the things that we believe. Hindi lang mahalaga na we believe at something, but we need to make sure that what we believe is healthy, what we believe is accurate. That's very important. Now, let's apply cognitive explanation in solving a practical problem. Halimbawa, ito. Let's say, paano ba nagbabago ang ginagawa ng isang tao? That's a very practical question. Paano nagbabago ang ginagawa ng isang tao? If you are going to connect everything I've said about cognitive explanation, the ancestor of every action is a thought, what's the answer to this question? You need to change the belief. Everything a person does goes back to the person's belief. Practical example, halimbawa, meron kang selosang girlfriend. Your girlfriend is very jealous and it's no longer good for the relationship. You are being suffocated. It's no longer doing good in your relationship. Madalas na kayo nag-aaway, madalas na kayo nagsisigawan, madalas na kayo nag-threaten each other to end the relationship because of the uncontrollable jealousy of this girlfriend. Eh, buti na lang, alam mo yung cognitive explanation. How can you solve this? Again, you identify what the behavior is. That's step one. Identify the behavior. Yun na muna. Ano ba yung behavior? The behavior here that we are trying to solve is being jealous. Anong sabi ng cognitive explanation? Behaviors can be traced back or can be explained by what? A person's belief. After you identify the behavior, now you trace back the belief. Bakit ba siya seloso o selosa? Ano ba yung pinaniniwalaan niya about sayo at siya ay selosa? Now you know. Kasi pala, yung girlfriend mo, meron siyang paniniwala that she cannot trust you. Hindi ko siya kayang pagkatiwalaan. And that thought, that thinking pattern is feeding the behavior. Kaya siya selosa. Kaya siya check ng cellphone mo. Kaya wala siyang tiwala sa'yo pag ikaw lang ang lumalabas mag-isa. Kaya niya laging chine-check yung Facebook account mo. Eh kasi yun ang iniisip niya sa'yo eh. You cannot be trusted. Therefore, how can you deal with this? Oh, edi gamitin mo yung cognitive explanation. You need to change this belief. That's the challenge. If you are successful in changing this belief, then what happens is the behavior will follow. Halimbawa, nagbago na. Nakumbinsi mo na siya na, hey, I am a boyfriend that you can trust. Hindi kita sasaktan. Kaya mo kong mapagkatiwalaan and she is convinced that you are telling the truth. What happens? Then, we assume, we can expect that that behavior will also change. Yung behavior niya dati, red. Eh dahil nagbago yung pag-iisip niya, magiging green na rin. Diba? Kasi, nabago mo yung kanyang paniniwala. You change that girl's belief, the way she treats you, the way she behaves in the relationship, will also change. But a very tough question to ask is, pero sir, eh paano to? Paano mo mapapalitan yung belief niya na dapat niya akong pagkatiwalaan? Well, dyan ngayon papasok yung sinasabi nating creativity. Bahala kayo dyan. Diba? Kanya-kanyang mga ways yan, kanya-kanyang mga techniques yan eh. You know? Pero there is one very important skill that I think you need to learn to effectively change people's beliefs. And that is the psychological skill of influencing other people. It's a psychological skill. Pinag-aaralan talaga yan. Diba? Or persuasion. The psychology of persuasion. Persuasion is your ability to change people's beliefs. And it's a skill that you can learn. Pero ito, pag-uusapan yan sa social psychology. Meron kayong subject called social psychology. Kung ako yung teacher nyo, tinuturo ko rin kasi ito. No? One of the lessons that we are going to talk about is a person's ability to persuade people to change beliefs. Alright? Pero, in closing lang, idagdag ko lang ito. No? Please ha, itong cognitive perspective na ito, don't take this too far. It's not as simple as you think it is. There are special cases where people's beliefs are so strong they are so hard to convince to believe in another belief. Like for example, kapag meron ng mga suicidal tendencies, 'di ba? Meron kang mga ganyang cases eh. Ang titibay ng mga beliefs niyan, like for example, if a person believes this, she believes wala nang value yung buhay niya. She believes she deserves to die. Ang hirap baguhin yan. Kaya nga in these cases, you need more than just persuasion. This person needs clinical help. This person needs counseling. At meron talagang field na counseling psychology. And you will talk more about this in clinical psychology. Ano bang ginagawa sa clinical psychology for us to be able to change unhealthy beliefs such as this? And this is very important, ha? This is very dangerous. Kapag yung ganyang thinking hindi napalitan, nako, it can lead to behaviors like this. Diba? Suicidal behaviors can be traced back to these kinds of beliefs. Kaya para maiwasan natin to, para hindi mangyari ito, ang kailangan natin gawin is, let's learn how to deal with this thought. And that is being discussed, being tackled in the field of cognitive psychology. Oh, sorry, counseling psychology, I mean. Okay? If you have any questions, mag-email lang kayo or mag-chat lang kayo sa, comment in the description box of this video. No? So, in summary, before we end, para lang hindi nyo makalimutan, today, we try to answer one very important question that psychologists, psych majors, should be able to answer. How to explain, dapat pala walang S. How to explain human behaviors. Ano ang sagot natin? In this video, we tackled three ways how to explain human behaviors. We have psychodynamic explanation. Ang focus niyan is the psychological entities. And then we tackled behavioral explanation, rewards and punishment. And then we tackled cognitive explanation. We tackled the role of beliefs in explaining human behaviors. So there you go. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to just post a question below sa description box. The next lesson we will tackle is part 2 of the same topic, explaining human behaviors. Thank you everyone for listening. Until next time, God bless and take care. Bye-bye.